Listening Library presents Blue, a history of the color as deep as the sea and as wide as the sky, by Nana Ekua Brew-Hammond. Read for you by Tashi Thomas. The color blue is all around us. Have you ever wondered where it comes from? It's in the sky, but you can't touch it. It's in the sea, but when you cup it, it disappears. You can crush iris petals for a brilliant shade, but just add water and away it fades. But then blue appears in the strangest places, discovered throughout history in unexpected ways. As early as 4500 BC, diggers found blue rocks called lapis lazuli in mines deep below Afghanistan's Sarai-Sang Valley. Ancient Egyptians used the rocks mostly to make jewelry. Some wore them as charms, believing they had the power to protect people from evil. But with time, they found new ways to use this underground find. By 44 BC, many Egyptians, including Queen Cleopatra VII, were applying a bluish mixture around their eyes that looked like eyeshadow made with ground lapis lazuli grains, plants, and animal fat. More than 600 years later, artists began painting sculptures, walls, and canvases with blue from the crushed rocks, too. It was a royal pain for those who made the paint, and so expensive only the wealthy could buy it. Since it was a luxury and in such high demand, for centuries, scientists, merchants, and dyers looked for more sources of blue. Then, on the shores of the Mediterranean, Central America, Mexico, and Japan, dyers found blue in the belly of certain shellfish. A Phoenician myth says a dog discovered the color. Finding a snail on the beach, the pup ate it up. The snail turned the dog's tongue purple-blue, and from that moment, a new industry was born. Dyers had different ways of releasing the color. In Mexico, they pressed the snail's foot. In the Middle East, they cracked its shell. Then they waited for the blue to appear. Depending on the snail, the color starts out a milky white or brownish yellow. But once it's in the air and the sun, it quickly turns green, then reddish purple, and with more sunlight, blue. But whether dyers pressed or cracked, snail blue was hard to produce. Each snail released just one or two drops. Imagine how many snails and drops it took to dye a royal robe, not to mention enough fabric to fill a merchant shop. Perhaps because blue was the color of the heavens, yet so rare and hard to create on earth, people around the world considered the color holy. In an old Liberian folktale.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.